is Shaq's penis right here. That's very nice. Thank you very much, Shaq. I'd love to see your penis, Shaq, if I could. Because I'm curious, because I'd love to see if it was, you know, if it's 6 inches, then you have a tiny cock, you know? That's what I want to see. I want to make me feel better. I want to make me feel good about my penis, which is really hard to do a lot of the times. Yeah, so I think I underdressed for this event a little bit. Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. I know I look like shit. I wanted to look as douchey as possible, so I dressed up like Eric Trump. If that works for you. I love it. Make Chicopee great again. That's really what I'm all about. Feels good, you know? I'm not really up to do comedy. I want to really talk about smoking. It's bad for you, you know? And saying that, I smoke about a pack a day. And I've heard, actually, this is actually a scientific fact, that if you smoke a lot, your penis will actually shrink up to 1 centimeter in your lifetime. Now, I don't believe that bullshit, because there's no way my dick can go back inside my body, you know? Like, it has to be outside, I think, you know? I'm not a dog. You know? Speaking of dogs, I saw a nice dog the other day. It was a terrier, and it upset me a lot because he had a boner, and I was like, I wish I had that dick. And I was just thinking, like, damn, fuck. Is there a way I can get a dog dick attached to my body? Because, like, it doesn't take much to make it bigger, you know? Like, I need that shit in my life. All right. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I also kind of think I look a little gay. But that's not me saying that. That's all the gay guys come up to me and being like, hey, are you gay? And I'm like, no, I'm not gay. I'm not, but thank you, because I really appreciate that compliment. You know, I don't get that a lot. I don't get a lot of girls come up to me and like, hey, are you totally heterosexual? And you're like, fuck me? Never. But gay guys, they're all like, yeah, let me get that dick. And I'm like, fuck, please, thank you. Oh, damn. You like that right there? Thank you. I know, it's good looking. You know, well, let's talk about my first hand job ever. Because I was like 16. I remember I had this girlfriend, you know. I thought she was cool because she said she wasn't a virgin. So I was like, oh, you probably know how to do hand jobs, right? You know? And she did not know how to do hand jobs. She is not a hand job person. I remember, like, you know, I'm 15 or 16 or whatever I was, you know, whatever, I'm confused. But I was getting ready for this hand job. She's, you know, she's, you know, pulling down my pants a little bit, pulling this, oh yeah, like, dick's getting out, it's getting hot and heavy. I'm looking forward to this sweet-ass hand job. Let's just say, she grabbed my dick like it was, like, an empty tube of toothpaste, and she started squeezing. Like, I don't know where you get this from, where you want to squeeze a dick as hard as you possibly can. But she did that, and I was like, okay. We'll start with that, that's fine. Okay, this will get better. No, then she started playing Wii Tennis with my cock. And she was like, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah. And, yeah, that was not, I mean, let's just say that was my first sexual experience. Should have been easy for me to come at this point, you know? I mean, honestly, I'm 15. I'm a teenager with a hard dick. Throw pennies at my dick, dude. Just start throwing pennies. I'll come. I'm gonna come at this point. I'm gonna get it. No, she did not. Yeah, she not loosen up or anything. She even spit on my dick. What kind? Like, do you watch porn at all? That's the first move you gotta do is just take your dick, spit on it, and you know, start rubbing that shit up. That's porn. That's all it is. Easy as pie. You know. So you know. I had to like stop this chick halfway through because, you know, the head of my dick was turning into like a mushroom cloud because all the pressure was getting pushed up into that part. So it was kind of like a nuclear bomb. So, you know, at one point or another, I had to be like, yeah, get the fuck off my dick. And she got up and she was real upset about it, you know, because she failed. She failed at like the only woman's job in the world, you know? Make sandwiches and jerk a dick off. That's all you gotta do. Come on, gals. You can do it. It's not that hard. You know? You could do both at the same time. You could fuck me with a sandwich. I'd come. I'd do it. I would make sure it happened. I'm good at this stuff, you know? I come all the time. But, you know, she got up and, you know, and then she started crying, you know, right next to the window. And she was, you know, just bawling tears. And then I finished, because I, you know, that's the way to finish right there. Nothing hotter than a chick crying to a bad handjob. All right, guys. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.